Hello and welcome to the TwoCast. This is our channel, and welcome to our USL Week 3 Team Builder in Battle versus Sky and the New York Mewtwos. I'm still a little bit sick. Hopefully it will wear off soon enough. So, we're currently 2-0 plus 8, second place in the league, hoping to still go right through our opponents and stay undefeated until week 5 at least. That's when we fight Thunderbug himself. And I really would like a battle of the undefeated people, right? The undefeated this time. Whatever. So Sky has a pretty defending team. He did make some trades, like the day of week 3, before, like, I finished my team the night before. He made trades. I forgot that I made my team, so I had to remake my entire team all over again. So it sucks, but I think I can handle his team. I think I can. So anyway, hopping straight into his team. He has Mew, Suicune, Arcanine. Arcanine Suicune is actually very hard to break usually, because like Arcanine and Suicune are in pairings really well together. Nidoqueen, which Nidoqueen's always a hell to prep for. Smurgle, which always just sets up hazards. Very fucking annoying. Granbull, Mega Heracross, which is very threatening under webs. Kieran Black, which is very threatening under webs as well. Ferrothorn, Sneasel, and Vicklebolt. So, I stared. Ryan helped me build. The coach of the London Lucarios. He helped me build. Very, very helpful. The passion, or the, I guess, drive to build just wasn't there at the time. So I asked, hey, I don't feel like building. Can someone help me? So I can get into the building process. Or else, if someone doesn't do that to help me, I'll just stare at a team for up to like 2 hours and do nothing. So hopping straight into it, me and him were talked about for the first thing that I wanted to do was something for lead Smeargle. And looking back through the DMs, we went through a lot of choices. We went through something like safety goggles. Skarmory, we went through other things like Pangoro, some sort of Pangoro set. I was looking at Jellicent, see if it could have done something. It had like magic code. And overall, we did decide, on Magic Bounce Espeon. And this set that I have is a complete counter to any really Smeargle set. Because, with the HP investment, there is zero way that Espeon, or a Smeargle at max attack, a Smeargle at max HP can endeavor us to any lower amount of HP. So, that basically means if we don't damage Smeargle, the only thing it can use to damage us back is an extreme speed, which doesn't do that much damage. So, we do outspeed. We don't outspeed Smeargle if it's max speed. we have Cobra Bear. I have Cobra Bear just in case Sneasel wants to do any shenanigans. Here are my notes on Espeon. I can pull them up. So, this is lead Espeon for lead Smeargle. If it is lead, Espeon versus lead Smeargle. Turn 1, Future Sight. Turn 2, this is all if he stays in for turn 1 and turn 2. Turn 1, Future Sight. Turn 2, Trick Room. Turn 3, Psychic or Dazzling Gleam, depending on if he has Sneasel to switch in. So this is basically the reason why Espeon is very good here. It's a complete counter to a Smeargle. And it's going to be very heat, and I'm going to love it. Next up, we have the powerhouse Mega Camel. Because Mega Camel, no switch-ins are on his team. There's nothing he has to switch in to Mega Camel. Excuse me. So if we can get Mega Camel in under a Trick Room, even if it's only like one or two turns, at least one mon is dying, and Mega Camel just pokes so many holes in his team for later in the game. Fire Blast and Earth Power, that hits the entirety of his team for what I want, so I put Sunny Day Solar Beam on just to have, you know, like, grass move for Suicune, and power to fire type moves, so that's good. Next up we have a hazard stacking Skarmory. Basically, he doesn't have much to remove hazards, except for Neon and Smeargle. So, I thought I should take advantage of that. Stealth Rock Spikes, that helps a lot versus his team, Roost and Ironhead. This is definitely a good, very good thing for Sneasel. And I have extra EVs for no reason. I don't know. Sure. Magic EVs. That's random. I don't really remember EVs on this. Ryan helped me a lot with his team, and he was the MVP. Next up, we have a Scarf Trick Jellicent. This is mostly for stuff like Combine Krokun, Hazard Setting Ferrothorn, Defensive Granpool, Defensive Arcanine, Defensive Mew, stuff like that. He has a lot of defensive mons that wouldn't appreciate having a Scarf. Then we have Toxic to Wear Down, stuff like Suicune. And it's a Scarf, you know, more rest. So we can weaken a lot of his defensive mons with Toxic and Scarf. So that's really helpful for us. Helps weaken a lot of his walls for stuff like Mega Camel and Dragonite later game. Next up we have a Gashibear Dragonite with a weird set, to say the least. This is Bulky DD. I am making a Bulky DD Dragonite set so that we can, just in case Ferrothorn gets up his own hazards, in case hazards go up on my side of the field, we do have a Defog Dragonite with Roost to help with longevity against stuff like Arcanine and Scarf Coon that we tricked. D-Dance and Dragonclaw, the only really thing that we need to get rid of for Dragonite to do a ton of work is Ferrothorn and Sneasel, which I believe I can take care of pretty easily. Considering I have Skarmory and Camel. So next up we have our Vixen, Ninetales Aurora Veil. So we're bringing Aurora Veil offense with Dragonite this week, which is very interesting. I've seen it once in the live. Shh, quiet. So Aurora Veil with Snow. 8 turns for Aurora Veil. Definitely good for Mega Camel because it will get 8 turns of where it's so bulky that you can't kill it. And it's going to kill you back. So we have Freeze Dry for your stuff like Suicune. So hit that for super effective. Moonblast for obvious. Cube, Sneasel, Mega Hera, and then HP Fire for Ferrothorn. So that's going to be our team builder. I'm so fucking kill me. To be honest, all these mons are very good against me. But I feel like he has to bring Granbull. He has to bring 6 of these mons. So you know, I don't know how much of to be honest, I don't know how much Smeargle is percentage by. I don't know how much that's going to really matter if it's coming or not. I guess this is kind of what I expect. It's so hard because Sky has a lot of good mons for my team. So I'll just have to see what he has for my team. And that's going to be our team builder part of the video. And we'll switch over to the battle. And I'll see you over there. Hello and welcome to the TreeCast. This is our channel. Welcome back to our battle. That's such a habit. Mega Hera is here. There is Cube here. No Smeargle. Sad. Sad boy. Sad boy. Sad boy. Ferrothorn is here. Sneasel's here. No Suicune, instead Nidoking. Which was a problem on my part, I thought. He has Nidoking instead of Nidoking, which was my problem. Yeah, that's all. So I could lead Ninetales. I think leading with Ninetales could be my best bet. Let me look at my let me import my sets. Still sucks that I didn't bring Smeargle. I had so much for it. Sad true. Ninetales. I could lead Camel. Yeah, I'm gonna lead Mega Camel. Cool. Clean matchup. Sacro? Do you have a Sacro? Nidoking. So bro, where is your sack? This needs to leave a knockout. They don't? Alright, that's fine. Take out, lose. No nice word. That is good. It's adamant non life water. Whatever else for this cube. Please tell me, please. Oof. Cloning percent. That's some clean damage. Dragonite, maybe? Can I just go into Ninetales? Go into my high school Vixen. Nice one, Kermit. That's a nice special attack. Turn black down, turn four, clean.
What?
One sec. This is gonna still take moves. What is it going to come to? The prediction off on the prediction. Do I think he's on the sky feet on? Espeon's not really worth it at this point. Espeon's not worth it because this is a circuit thing. Not as much as expected. I could bring in Mega Camel again, because it just forces him. Mega Camel just forces something to come in and take another Fire Blast, which is okay for me. Because unless this is Sash Sneasel, the only thing that can take a Fire Blast from my Mega Camel is Mew. And I can't take two. Well, Sneasel's gone. I don't think he's life orb. Miles. Which would be true. This one. Yeah, he's life orb. Non life orb would do 60-70. Which is modest. There's no way he wouldn't do that much. Sack down. And I think I can go into jelly now. I can either go into jelly or I can go into Dragonair. I feel like Dragonair might be in for a better idea. Thank you. I'm gonna go into Vixen. Alright, that's what I needed. I could have set up the lure though, but I might have just maybe fucked up. Perhaps. It's 4-3. I've gone to Dragonite. That's true. I could go. No, I can't go into Jelly and start myself. Just something. Maybe go into Skarm, perhaps. Instead of hazards. Taking the 3 turns to die, though. And it'll happen with each key. So my best bet, I believe, is Dragon right now. And the question is, do I Dragon Dance or do I not Dragon Dance? God, why did I have to bring both the demon for once? Heracross does get knocked off, right?
Does.
There's always a possibility that's offensive move in the back. It'd be honestly super dumb to try to set up again. Be prepping for hazard. Maybe I'm just making this bulky Dino this problem. Like, making this bulky Dino might have been like one of my problems. And dodging. I I can't beat Ferrothorn at this point. Like, if he's offensive Mew, I think I lose. Because the only way I'd win at that point would be trying to beat Ferrothorn with what I have. That's possible. Now I can set up on Ferrothorn. Shadow Ball do. No, he does go into Ferrothorn though. I'm gonna Scarf Jellison. I can't win at this point. Ah, I needed Michael Cannon. Okay. Please load the dish for the only way I can win is if I stall. I'm not gonna move to stall. This is the only way I can win if he's not next attack.
This is so dumb.
The only way I can win is if I can set up on you. Which I don't see happening anytime soon. I don't enjoy this. I do not very much enjoy this at all. Oh, fuck me, bro. I've installed out 2 Pokemon. So there's a bunch of 3 Ice Beams. I have to go into Skarm. Skarm is now my incoming. I can do this all day, bro. This is not fun. Thank you. I'm very sorry about this. This is such a terrible game. Ugh. What is this last move? Can I at least just only do toad? Heracross. I don't know if he can knock me out, but really? Oh no. Alright. Should kill here. Skirm. Wow, that did nothing. Sigh. That's gonna be it for that terrible thing. Go ahead and subscribe, it really helps the channel. If you wanna see more? No, where to look. Goodbye. Can I click stop recording? Notifications stop. Fucking notifications.